Hello students, now we'll see the next illustration, illustration number 5. See the illustration. Mr. Sanand Kumar is a chartered accountant in Bangalore. He has submitted the following income and expenditure account for the year 2019-20. Compute his income from profession for the assessment year 2020-21. Note, interest from post office saving banks is exempt up to ₹3,500 under section 10, subsection 5. So here they have given the income and expenditure account. So the debit side shows about the expenses. See one by one. To office rent ₹66,000. To salary to staff ₹1,50,000. To charities ₹10,000. To gift to relatives ₹12,000. Subscription to journals ₹4,800. Drawings ₹32,000. Car expenses ₹48,000. Household expenses ₹17,200. NSE purchase ₹40,000. On income side, audit fees ₹6 lakh, financial consultancy services ₹1,20,000, by interest on deposit in a bank ₹44,000, by dividend on units of UTI ₹12,000, by accountancy work ₹64,000. So the net income is ₹4,60,000. Total of both the side is ₹8,40,000. See the additional information. Office rent ₹6,000, though paid, is not recorded. Depreciation of car during the year is ₹12,000. 30% of car expenses are related to personal purpose. So with this information, with the help of income and expenditure account, we have to prepare the we have to find out the taxable income of a Mr. Sanand Kumar from his profession for the assessment year 2020-21. So here they have given the details about a chartered accountant in Bangalore. The given details about the chartered accountant in Bangalore. So that is about the profession. So with the help of a professional income and professional related expenses, we have to consider what is his total taxable income from his profession. So to find the taxable professional income, we have to see first the professional related incomes, that is to write the professional receipt. So we'll see the income side. So on the income side, they have given the sum of the incomes which is received by a chartered accountant. So first one is audit fees. So this chartered accountant, for auditing work, for checking the records, so he has received a audit fees for checking the records or for verifying the records or records of books of different businesses or companies. He has received, this chartered accountant or a CA received audit fees. So that is taken as his income he is receiving from his profession. So that is nothing but audit fees is taken as a professional receipt. So we have to take under receipt. Financial consultancy services, for the financial consultancy services he has received ₹1,20,000. So that is also taken as his receipt relating to profession. Then interest on deposit in a bank is not relating to his profession. Dividend from unit of UTI is also not relating to his profession. The accountancy work, for accountancy work he received 64,000 amount, that is because of his profession. So this accountancy work amount we have to add to his professional receipt. So here interest on post office saving bank account exempt up to 3,500 is given. It is not required for our calculation. We are calculating professional receipt, so that is not required. So now see the expense side of income and expenditure account. Under that, first one is office rent. So relating to office rent, first one is office rent ₹66,000. So it is taken as a professional related payment. So here this chartered accountant, for the rent of his building, office rent he has been paid. So that is taken as his professional related expenses relating to his office and administrative expenses. Salary to staff also, he paid a salaries to his staff. So that is also taken as his professional payment. Charity is not taken as a professional payment. Gift to relative, it is given gift to relative, it is not taken as a professional payment. Then subscription for journal, so he has been paid for the sum of money ₹4,800 for subscription for the journals. So these journals are relating to his profession, so it is taken as a professional payments. Then drawings is taken as a personal one, so it is not taken as a professional payment. Car expenses, if it is used for a profession purpose, then we have to consider. Then household expenses is relating to house, it is not relating to profession, we have to ignore. NSE purchased also not relating to profession, we have to ignore. So next is additional information. So under the additional information, first one they have given office rent of rupees 6,000 though paid, not recorded. So here 6,000 office rent is paid, one more office rent of 6,000 is paid, but it is not recorded. So here income tax deduction can be claimed for any payment what is paid. Whatever the expenses he paid, then he can claim a deduction. So office rent 6,000 he has been paid but not recorded here. So while computing this office rent, while taking the value of 66,000, we have to add 6,000 also, because there is a office rent he actually paid but not recorded here. So that value we have to take while taking the office rent. So the value is equal to office rent 66,000 plus 6,000 we have to take. Next, second additional information, depreciation of car during the year is 12,000. So we can charge a depreciation, we can record a depreciation of 12,000. So here on the expenses, they have not given about the car purchased value of car. So they directly given the depreciation amount. So this 12,000 we can record on the, we can take it as a professional payment, and we can record on the, under the head professional payment. So there is a one more adjustment relating to car here. 30% of car expenses are related to personal purpose. 30% of the car expenses are related to personal purpose, means out of 100%, 30% is relating to personal purpose, means the balance 70% is taken for the profession. So balance 70% is relating to profession. So here car expenses, we have to calculate the car expenses here, 48,000. So that is, we have to take only 70%, because we have to take, while calculating the professional payment, we have to take the professional payment or professional expenses which is relating to profession. So that is the car expenses which is relating to profession. How much the car expenses relating to profession is nothing but 70%. So only 70% we have to take under the head professional payment for the car expenses. That is 48,000 into 70% we have to take. And again, similarly for the depreciation, while taking the depreciation, we should not take the total 12,000. Here 30% of that car is used for the personal purpose. So the total car expenses, even the depreciation also taken as a car expenses. So for taking depreciation also, we have to take 70%. So 12,000 into 70%, we have to calculate the depreciation. Okay, so here date of purchase of the car is not given, so we have to charge full depreciation, but we have to take only 70% of the depreciation as well as the car expenses while computing the professional payment. So now work out the illustration, write the heading solution. So now we'll work out the solution for the illustration number 5. Write the heading: computation of taxable income from profession of Mr. Sanat Kumar for the assessment year 2020-21. So here the Sanat Kumar, he is a chartered accountant. So here as a chartered accountant, he is receiving many of the income from his profession, as well as he is incurring some of the expenses in connection to his profession. So now we have to compute what is his taxable amount of income from his profession. So firstly, we have to take draw three column particulars and two amount column. So firstly, we have to take about his professional receipt. So as a professional employee or a chartered accountant, he is receiving a professional incomes like he is receiving audit fees rupees 6 lakh, financial consultancy services he received amount 1,20,000, and for accountancy work he received 64,000. So the total professional receipt, so write one by one: audit fees. So the professional receipt, audit fees is 6 lakh, financial consultancy services 1,20,000, accountancy work 64,000. So only 3 items he is receiving from his profession. So the remaining 2 is not relating to his profession, so we have to ignore. So now total of this professional receipt, 6 lakh plus 7,20,000, 6 lakh plus 1,20,000 plus 64,000 is equal to 7,84,000. So this is the total receipt he received from his profession. Now this total receipt is not taxable, he can claim a deduction for the professional expenses. He can claim a deduction or he can reduce his income by deducting his professional related expenses. Professional expenses or professional related payments. So now we'll deduct one by one the professional expenses or payment. So on the debit side, they have given office rent 66,000. So write office rent. The first item, first expense he incurred is office rent. So the given value is 66,000. So the given value is 66,000. So along with this office rent, there is a one more office rent 6,000 he has been paid, but that is not recorded in the above in the above income and expenditure account. So we have to record that also. So the total office rent 66,000 he paid, 66,000 plus one more 6,000. Office rent also he has been paid, so that whatever the total expenses he paid relating to profession can be deductible here. So 66,000 plus 6,000 is equal to 72,000. Next is salary to staff is relating to profession. So write salary to staff. So the salary to staff value is rupees 150,000. Next, charities are not relating to profession. Gift is given to relatives, not taken as a professional payment. Subscription to journal. So he has been written as some of the journal. For that he has paid a subscription. So subscription journals are writing because of their profession. So subscription for journals. He has written articles in some of a journal. For that he has paid some fees, a subscription for journals. So the amount is 4,800. So that is taken as a professional payment. Then drawing is relating to personal, it should not be taken. Car expenses we can deduct if this car is expenses are relating to profession. So relating to car, they have given the 30% of car expenses are related to personal purpose. So now write car expenses. So car expenses, out of total car expenses, so the car expenses given how much? 48,000. Out of total car expenses, 48,000. The entire is not relating to professional purpose. 30% is relating to his personal purpose. So the remaining 70% is taken for professional purpose. 70% is relating to professional purpose. So 48,000 into 70% is equal to 33,600. Next one, household expenses is not relating to profession. NSE purchased also not relating to profession. So the expense side over. So again, see the additional information. Office rent 6,000 we have added along with the office rent which is recorded on the expense side. Then depreciation of car during the year is 12,000. So there is a depreciation of car for the year 12,000, but they have not recorded on the expense side. So we can claim a deduction for the depreciation. So that is a depreciation on car we can take. So the total depreciation given is 12,000. So out of 12,000, here the relating to car, the expenses relating to car is used for personal purpose is 30%. So even the depreciation expenses also we have to consider only the professional related, that is the 70% is professional purpose. So we have to consider only the professional purpose of depreciation, that is 12,000 into 70%. So that is equal to rupees 8,400. So next, there is no other payments or expenses in the illustration. So now total 72,000, 150,000, 4,800, 33,600, 8,400 is equal to 268,800. So if you deduct professional expenses from a professional receipt, you will get balance value 5,15,200 is nothing but the taxable income from his profession. So this chartered accountant has actually received a income from his profession is 7,84,000. So up to 2,68,800 he can claim a deduction for the expenses whatever he incurred in connection with the profession. So the balance amount 5,15,200, on this amount he has to pay his tax. So this 5,15,200 should be taken under Section 28 of a Income Tax Act while computing his GTA, while computing his gross total income. Under Section 28, we have to take 5,15,200 as his professional income. Next, write note for the office rent. The first note, office rent of rupees 6,000 can be deductible since it is paid. Next, second one, depreciation as well as car expenses is considered only for the professional purpose. That is at a 70% first up. So there is no other info. So this is about this illustration, simple illustration it is.